the most exhilarating and intense dirt track racing in the world. Immerse yourself in a celebration of the legacy and leader in dirt track open wheel racing at the Sprint Car Capital of the World. Advance tickets to all April through September 2013 events on sale now at KnoxvilleRaceway.com.
Talk about a crappy way to die. Drunk, tried to jump up to his balcony to get into his house, and literally off of 6 feet, fell, landed on his forehead, and broke his neck.
Oh my God.
He was the funnest guy, too.
What's his name?
Dave Noyes.
Dave Noyes, just a friend?
A college friend. He was one of those guys that was like, and you know what really sucks is that once he died, I got to talk to Eddie, my buddy, my gay friend.
Your gay chicken.
My gay chicken
soulmate.
Friend. I talked to Eddie, and there was so much that I did not know about Dave that and you know, it's like you're so selfish in relationships that you just talk to someone on the surface. It's like
you're waiting for your turn to talk.
Exactly. You don't really get to know. This is the funniest part. I'm telling Eddie, and Eddie said, you know, you had a trust fund. That's why he never really worked. I went, I didn't know he had a trust fund. He's like, yeah, he got $20,000 a month, so he never really worked. But you know, and I think that's why he drank. And we were talking about it, and I was like, holy crap. And Eddie goes, yeah, man, I was talking to my brother. I go, you have a brother? He goes, yeah, I have a brother. And I go, wait, shut up. Eddie, I've known Eddie my whole life. I've known him. I knew he had a sister, but he's got a brother who's 10 years older from his dad's first marriage. And I was like, you never talked about him. And he goes, well, I'm just gossiping about Eddie's brother, but there's a reason they never talked. And I went, shut up. And I was like, oh my God. I am so selfish in a relationship. I didn't know anything about anybody. Everyone knows everything about me because I just talk about me nonstop.
Well, and if you're like me, you're probably trying to think of how can I make fun and joke about this?
Yeah.
And so while they're talking, you're like, okay, I'm formulating something funny in my head here.
I don't even
listen. So you're missing out some of this
stuff.
Well,
my wife talks.
Like when I mentioned earlier about my sickle cell problem.
Yeah, right. We all like that. And then, what?
No. You remember that?
Did you like my acting right there?
5 minutes ago.
Acting. Acting. Rob Thomas. The, I definitely don't listen. When my wife tells me a story, sometimes I just literally go, how rude for her to tell such a boring story. how dare you really, really say this is important. She talked about farm club.
What?
She runs a farm club in LA at our school.
What, planting vegetables and stuff?
No. Sheeps and
that's a thing?
Yes.
You raise sheep and you get with people and talk about how you raise
sheep? Pigs, chickens,
guinea pigs. Do they take this field trip to Iowa?
In L.A.?
In L.A.
Weird.
And so she runs it. And
she's telling you all about it.
And she tells me about it. And I'm, you know the only thing more boring than farming? Telling someone about farming. Raising animals.
Unless you're another farmer.
Unless you're another farmer. But you're a stand-up comedian who has a TV show. You're probably not interested.
My wife tells me about her crafting stuff. And I'm like, tell me more. Oh. It's I have to work to listen to that stuff.
Yeah.
God bless her because she's trying to make money off it and she enjoys it, but
yeah.
It's really hard for me to pay attention.
Oh, she will get into a conversation about, the other day she goes, I need to be more, I'm straight up gossiping about my wife. She goes, I need to be more involved in your business. She just doesn't understand anything about the internet. She didn't get anything about the internet.
She wants to Yoko you.
She goes, I need to be more involved. I should be helping you. Get your podcast up. And I was like, babe, you would have no idea. You know how long it would take me to explain to you how to upload a podcast? She goes, well, why don't you email me a couple of them so I can listen to them? And I go, you don't email someone a podcast. I go, you go and get it. It's on an RSS feed. You just download it. And she goes, I don't want to download it because what if it puts a disease in the computer? I go, a disease? You can't. I go, first of all, we have an Apple. We're safe, okay? Second of all, it's my podcast. It's on my website. I don't have any viruses. And she was like, well, I just think I should be more involved. I should be really helping you get to the next level. And I was like, just do what you're doing. Just work at Farm Club. You're exhausting me just having this conversation.
You are, babe. Just being my babe.
Yeah.
I love you.
I just need you to drive when I drink too much.
That's
the rule, for the record. Just so you know, 22 years old, that's the rule. You go on a date with a dude, okay, and you love that dude, and you've had too much to drink, and he's had too much to drink, you drive because you're the woman. You take the charge because, yeah.
You hear that, Katie, who's videotaping? Is Bert's giving you valuable life lessons?
Because
here.
If the dude gets a DUI and goes to prison, his stakes are higher than your stakes. He's got to learn how to shuck and jive in the shower when you just got to learn how to braid hair. It's not a big deal if you go to jail.
Just take the other.
Yeah. I'm the franchise player. My wife is Dwayne Wade or Chris Bosh. Like, I am LeBron James. I go to prison, our family is screwed. But if my wife goes to prison, we'll get over it.
You're the meal ticket with that huge show on Travel Channel.
Huge.
Trip Flippers.
Huge.
He's a tripper.
My wife doesn't drink, thankfully, so she always drives. Our one thing now is driving.
That's nice, by the way.
She drinks. She'll have like a glass of wine, but she never drives more than a glass of wine. She doesn't like to lose control. I was like, I wouldn't mind seeing what that looks like.
Oh,
one night, hot. One of these days. Fire.
Have you thought about like half a roofie?
No.
Just to simulate being drunk.
She'd fall asleep. She raises two kids all day. She'd be like, right. I'm out. Good night.
Dude, she'd Family Guy face plant.
Family Guy face plant.
Where the arm flips over the back. Yeah. And Bert Kreischer at the Funny Bone this weekend. I don't know if I mentioned that at all. But you are there.
Yep.
So go to the
Thursday,
show.
Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and I'm home Sunday for Father's Day.
And he's a funny guy. He's a good guy. You're a good guy.
I'm a good guy, I feel like.
I remember I called you once about I needed somebody's info on something, and you called me back. I appreciate that.
Although I did just get your text.
Are you on AT&T?
Yeah.
There you go.
Is that what it is?
I think so.
Shut up.
Well, I've heard AT&T sucks in the big cities.
Oh, yeah.
So you're going with that excuse then?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Bert Kreischer, as always,
I
really,
love you,
it's a pleasure.
You.
I love you.
I love you, too.
I really do.
I love you.
Come here. Give me a kiss.